statue, you see pixelation to go.
The movement. There's not really a space that might be there. So if you're thinking more of the aesthetics in the space. So the idea that I had after our conversation was sort of this.
Checking it out.
Okay. It looks cool.
I only recently got it and I just wanted to see what kind of a shot.
Lovely, it's lovely. drawing out your last syllable, I could say it and then drawing out your last
The spotlight would be on the movement, and the chorus would be like, the person would be disembodied voice.
Lost my body now. Nice. But I also like, I mean, and then, from what I understood from what you're saying, was that at times it would be the image instead of the body.
The moving image.
The moving image.
Maybe just once that in that case.
Yeah, I would think that there's movement.
Yeah.
It's either body movement or like a mechanized movement, but there's some movement. If it's a still image, maybe if there's a chorus and a still image, it should substitute. Only movement should be substituted for the body. Like if there's a chorus and an image, if there's a quotation and an image, there should be, I think, movement, dance movement.
Or maybe if you were gonna have no movement, no dancer or moving image, then you'd like the chorus.
Yes.
Ooh.
I'm excited.
Yeah, I like that
too. I think it's interesting if that's a very good suggestion.
Well, we can also do something like
What were you going to say?
I was just going to say that I think the stark moments of moving images where it's like some of the images don't have that much sound, but they have like kind of a low buzz or frequency happening. I think like the breaks of the moving images need to happen where there's nothing else going on. Because it can be overwhelming. I think it's like a nice minimal break when it's just the moving images and nothing else. And nobody's
doing it. Doesn't mean it's
No, the films. Like I think the film is really beautiful when all the
interior
just and that like all the sound in that is so minimal and beautiful.
That should be done on the sun, right?
Yeah.
That's needed.
Yeah.
But you also mean the green machine.
I don't think there should be anything going on during moving images, other than moving images personally. But
no, they're so beautiful and there's only two of them. I mean there's
Kurosawa.
There's
Kurosawa and then there's
Wild
the sleep. That one is amazing. I think all three of those are really
And they're very short.
Yeah.
30 seconds maybe. The
they just provide like a break from all this texture that's going on and all the speaking.
So some people say that before the sun came in. But it's no longer like it once was, because now we float in dreamlands of rain and sunshine. And I took note of the following. That we run on automatic pilot and lost the body for all the intensity of my songs.
There are moments in the music where, like, I'm being kind of playful, even at times, where, like, he's talking about, like, this really intense experience, and I'm playing, like, You Were My Sunshine. It's like, there was, like, this girl, the mouth, meth, like, she was naked, and I'm like,
it's very clear in the program. This is not a theater, it's not a performance, it's a theater piece edging into ritual. So it has that heavy feeling, it's contrasting with You Were My Sunshine.
Thank you.
Twilight, she said, when you could still be filming with the street lights on and be within the bounds of Magic Earth. It presents a playoff between the illusions cast in the cave by flaming fire on one hand. What about the letting you get to the end of the paragraph?
No, wouldn't it be your best?
Huh?
Wouldn't it be your best? And then, when you finish the phone call, look at all of us.
History of creation presents a playoff between the illusions cast in the cave by flame and fire on the one hand.
I've been calling for a while.
It takes a long time.
sunshine and no alternative on the nothing new. What follows here, he said, is an experiment in the technique of awakening. An attempt to become aware of the dialectical and Copernican return of remembrance. Aimed at giving the angel of history a leg up so as to once more fly. Compelled by the re-enchantment of the sun as meltdown recharges the poetry of nature, especially when flying, this theater becomes ritual, leading on the doors of paradise. I shortened Act 3 a little and tried to make it clear, so I want you guys to listen. Peter's running around all the time, but Kira, maybe Kira and Farida could share one.
Share the instructions?
I have it on
my computer. I sent
it to you?
Didn't you?
Yeah, I think so. It's called 23 or 24 or something.
Send it today.
Yeah, I have
23.
Oh, wait, is it
24? Yeah, but I think 24 is basically the same as 23. It's like Detroit, they have a new Model E everywhere, that's all.
I was thinking that at some point we should just make a decision about at when is it for each act, a few minutes at the beginning of each act,
oh,
or
right,
just
right,
when the cues
important.
Are, and
yeah.
Then Peter can run the cues, like physically. what
yeah.
that collaboration
yeah, that's fine.
Is
I mean, you can run it, or yeah, if you want to send it to us, we can run it. I mean,
yeah.
It's all good. You know what I'm saying? Whatever works best for the piece works best.
This is something we have to think about. The animation for like just run for 3 minutes at the end, beginning of each act, or more frequently, longer period.
I feel like we'll know when we just see it at the space park.
Yeah, we'll know tomorrow.
It's probably hard to decide now.
Can't decide now.
Yeah.
And they're putting up the screens now, or mm-hmm. tomorrow? The screens will be in place tomorrow.
Should
screens are in place now. Shooting into the fabric from outside.
Oh, yeah, that'd be lovely, but not too cold. They said tomorrow's going to be warmer.
I think they like the cold. I think they like the cold a lot.
Me too.
The projector.
Yeah, yeah. Projectors. I mean, Norwegians, yeah.
We have a performance in here.
Oh, okay. We're going to be there.
Okay, cool. Sorry, I didn't want to.
Are you guys set, like meeting the
studio right now?
You are going to come in
yeah.
5 minutes.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. Speaking mimetically, you know, getting something parallel, the quote-unquote firefly dance would start, what was the world like before the sun?
Mm-hmm.
Well, doesn't it come in when the music comes in?
When what?
When the music and the strobe comes in, or before that?
Well, I think that entering when, what was the world like before the sun, I think it links nice into the text, and it also gives you a chance to dance before the music, right? So I think that's a nice...
It's nice if they come in sort of one...
And then the other is a
layer,
it's a bridge. I think that's really nice.
Can I just direct your attention to something? There's a paragraph halfway down which begins, hear the great drama.
On that page?
So what was the role of the...
The sunshine, having no alternative but nothing new. As the rain bends and the sun shines, the little boy so fearless in the end. Well, there is no end. Not like the word think, as when we say the sun sang in the west, whether there be water or not. The most frequently evoked of all sinkings is the sun setting as a blaze of flame on an iridescent sea, like the blacksmith. You may come into action in front of the wind. Today the peasant speaks the sound of Christ, or with an old Indian shaman moving slowly over the sky. Well, that was good. Getting there. We only took an hour and 8 minutes with quite a few interruptions, but we didn't see the videos. So you guys have got to coordinate with my daughter. I can't push her around too much. You've got to talk to her. She listens to you. She doesn't listen to me.
I think Peter should run the images unless we need a video of yourself part of it.
Well, you're very familiar now.
Yeah.
That's the idea. Is anyone else? Yeah, it's right at the end, the evening star, the morning star.
As much fire as possible.
Huh?
I support any kind of fire, any sort of pyrotechnics. Yeah. Just such a simple thing. Yeah.
I have one question, sort of one thing that kind of happened tonight for the first time when you were telling me, this is something else concerning the relationship between you and the dance, but you said you had me sort of stand there and were narrating over my body in a way. And I think that's great. I think there should be more of, it should have more of that kind of relationship that when I'm dancing, it's as if, you know, I'm in some little music box on your desk. I'm also one of these things, one of these sort of anthropological artifacts that you've brought into this sun theater.
Why do you mean like the bag?
Somehow that, yeah, it's, you know, because there's many things that are pointed to in the piece, and I think the dance should also, I mean, the dance is of itself, but you're also pointing to it in a way. So you shouldn't feel like you have to detach when I'm dancing. I think rather it's, you know, we can be engaged together there. And probably with the music we can do the same as well. We're sort of vibing together. I think that would be, I don't know if that's, that seemed like it was kind of starting, and I would love to develop that more.
Like when you were the world.
Yes. Yes, exactly.
Let's see what we can do.
Yeah,
let me know if there's other places.
6.
So I think we can go. You think we can start? Think we can start? Picture Nietzsche in the volcanic mountains of Morelos. Popocatapetl, ash drifting, skyward drifting.
Risk it all these juveniles.
Me? No, I go there twice. I've been there twice this semester. It's at 5 o'clock when I miss had anyone there. Shouldn't we have the image there? He's dancing in front of the image.
In this sublimity, I spat out sparks of night sun, fireflies, fragments of a flaming corpse, truly the sun gives without receiving, as in this photograph by Dan Toro one summer in Pennsylvania. Late twilight, he writes, but full moon, a long exposure of 10 to 15 minutes to accumulate enough fireflies and enough light for the landscape to be seen as landscape. I remember setting up the camera and opening the lens and going down the hill and frying up some onions for dinner.
The mountains are blue to the west. Here they sit, leaning forward, mesmerized, staring at the setting sun.
A burly man grasps his female companion in the parking lot.
Like statues.
Who's this? I'm busy. In the theater. What's it about? I haven't got time. It's about the re-enchantment of nature in the age of global meltdown. But that's right, about reclaiming geosensuality. Take care.
Solemn forms appear to us, approach, and glide away, leaving us in tears. Let us follow Proust on these nightly expeditions through the sleeping body. For this is our sun theater of black ice and black gravel. Let us follow Proust on these nightly expeditions as did Walter Benjamin in his voyage into the subterranean city. Architecture, fashion, yes, even the weather.
city which dream now.
Sunshine, having no alternative, on the nothing new. The sunshine, having no alternative, on the nothing new.